After controlling the data, we have to ask ourselves a new question. What kind of analysis can we do with our data? There are fundamentally two main types of analysis that we can do with our data: descriptive statistics and multivariate analysis. Descriptive statistics are always the first set of analysis to perform in order to obtain an overview of the data and a preliminary understanding. However, we can rarely draw significant conclusions on the base of purely descriptive analysis. To test the research hypothesis that we have formulated at the beginning of our journey, we need to perform multivariate analysis. The fundamental descriptive statistics are univariate, that is, they consider one variable at a time. The first usual descriptive statistics are the measures of central tendency: the mean, which is the average of all values; the median, which is the central observation and is not influenced by outliers; the mode, which is the most frequent observation, that is, the most probable value. In this example of exam grades, we can see the difference among the three measures of central tendency. The mean is 22.29. Note the grades are only integer values, while the mean can be in between two grades. The median is 22, that is the central grade, while the mode is 18, which is the most frequent grade. Other fundamental descriptive statistics are the measures of dispersion, that tell us how much the data are scattered far away from the mean. The usual measures are the range, that is the difference between the maximum and the minimum value; the variance, that is the average square difference between each value and the mean; the standard deviation, that is the square root of the variance. In the figure, we can see an example of two different variables. They have the same mean, but the red line is more dispersed than the blue one. Indeed, the red has a standard deviation that is twice the one of the blue. A final univariate statistic that may be interesting is the skewness, which gives us a measure of the asymmetry of the distribution. A positive value means a distribution with a tail to the right, like the one in the figure. A negative value means a tail to the left. A symmetric distribution has skewness equal to zero. But the opposite is not necessarily true. The univariate statistics we have seen so far can be used with both continuous and discrete data, that are data measured through interval or ratio scales. If data are measured through nominal or ordinal scales, the concepts of central tendency and dispersion do not apply. Rather, we can calculate the frequency of observation of each value. In this example of descriptive statistics for a nominal scale, we see the distribution of the IPS sample in the various countries. We count the frequency of observation of each category and we calculate the related percentages.